guys. It's been a while. I know life has just gotten really busy since my kids have gotten older. It's really crazy. I've been out of town. If you've been watching my recent videos, you'll know that I mentioned that I was going out of town for a scrapbook retreat, and I'm back. And so today I'm going to share just some scrapbook layouts with you. And these are layouts that I did a guest design team spot for Kiwi Lane on their blog for the month of September. And then I have some layouts to share with you that I did at the retreat. And I have some layouts that I've just recently worked on as well to try to kill that kit. And so I'm going to share all these layouts with you. Then I'll be back in another video to share with you the classes that were offered at the retreat. And it was a part of the retreat from the different manufacturers in Salt Lake. So that was really fun. So I'll share those in a separate video so I can go over kind of what we did in class and stuff like that. So let's get started. So back in September 22nd, I was a guest designer for Kiwi Lane Designs, and I used to design for them once upon a time, and occasionally they have me back as a guest spot designer for their blog or a blog hop designer. So I wanted to share really quickly, I did three projects for them, and they co-created with Bella Boulevard, which I was ecstatic because I love Bella Boulevard. I love the bright, fun colors. It's just totally my style. So I made, what you're looking at, I made three projects. They were all layouts. This one happens to be a Project Life layout. And I used a We Are Memory Keepers pocket page here, not a Becky Higgins, but they're all the same basically. This actually is a Becky Higgins Project Life card. I believe it's from the Honey collection. So I use the templates, and let me share with you what a template is in case you're unfamiliar with Kiwi Lane, and you can look them up. They're basically old school templates. They come out with a lot of these different kind of patterns and designs, and they kind of are to help you frame out your scrapbook layout before you cut into your paper. I find them very helpful for using pattern papers and a lot of patterns together, and that's why I really like them, because if I want to use up a lot of my pattern papers and not always use a solid background, I grab my Kiwi templates. So you basically just trace it and cut it out. So it's definitely old school with the scissors. All right, so I used a couple of the templates on here. Up here, I used a template where it has these little potty people with the hearts, and I just kind of framed out the photo of my husband and I. And then here's a scallop border right here, and I used a scallop template here. And then this giant kind of heart here is on the outside of the page protector. That was another Kiwi template. So those were the templates that I used just to kind of add a little bit of something to my Project Life pocket page layout. I don't go overboard with my layouts when I do a pocket style, because why? That's really not the object of fast scrapbooking, is just to get them in the pockets. And so I like just to add a little bit here and there and not go overboard. Plus I kind of like to keep these layouts a little bit more flatter so I can get more in the album. So that was one thing I did for Kiwi Lane. The second one is from a paper collection still from Bella Boulevard, and it's called Family Forever. And as you can see, there's a lot going on, and that's what I like, that I can make a lot going on and it still looks good. There's a lot of patterns I can play with when I use the templates. I have scallops, and I have strips, and I have the circle, and this is a flower template and an arrow. And I added in a bunch of older supplies from Bella, which that's what I love about their products as well. You can mix a lot. So like this paper here did not, it went with the collection, but this did not, but it still matches perfectly. So that was great. And I love that they offer feathers that match their papers, and it's just a fun little whimsical accent. And then I have some buttons, and those are the chip pieces there. But it's really fun to work with their papers. And then the last one that I made for Kiwi is a boy layout, and it's with the paper collection Max from Bella. And as you can see, I just did a lot of template layering here. I really wanted to bring out the words in this paper right here, intelligent, strong, and awesome, and I love that. I just added some more of the different papers on with the different templates. This is Heidi Swap. And then I just backed my photos with a black mat so they'd pop off the page a little bit more since there's a lot of busy patterns. And then I added these little monsters that are dimensional, and they're from Paper Studio. And I have, you can see around this star cluster here that I have some glitter going on. It's from a gel pen. And I added these monsters. They are not Bella Boulevard, but they went perfectly with the Bella paper. Loved that. So really fun layout of my husband and my boys. And so that's what I created for Kiwi Lane for September. Now, let me show you really quickly the layouts that I made at the retreat. So I took a paper collection with me, and I shared that video just recently of the kit that I put together, what I traveled with to the retreat since it was in Utah. I didn't want to travel with a whole lot, so I made up a little kit again like I like to do to use up my supplies. So all these layouts I'm going to share with you pretty much came from those supplies, unless otherwise they were layouts that I made at home and I may have grabbed a few things. But these right here I'm going to share are from the retreat. So the first one here is just a white cardstock. It's textured. These are the Chamel Lane 6x6 papers here in the background. This white and black stripe here is actually Heidi Swap Dream, I believe. And I added the photos on. These are some Me and My Big Idea overlay stickers that are clear. Then I did a little bit of snap labels down here. This is from Chamel Lane's die cuts, a Heidi Swap heart, a bow, and then these are some enamel arrows that I got at the Scrapbook Expo. And I stamped and I drew on this layout. So all of these circles that you're seeing here, I actually drew them with a Kiwi Lane template with my pen. So this was the Kiwi template. I just laid it on my page and I drew. And then after I had them randomly drawn on my page, I took a stamp, and it was another stamp that I received at the expo. And it had this really cool arrow on it, so I kind of rounded my arrow to fit inside there as I stamped it. And so that's how I got the stamp to fit inside there. And then I have some Heidi Swap mist just kind of splattered, and then I drew with the mist as well all the way around my layout. So it does have a really cool, messy kind of look to it if you look really closely. So that's the first one. And then I have some clear Me and My Big Idea hearts and arrows up here at the top. And then this one is of my youngest son when he was a lot younger. And this one is really easy. Once again, this is Heidi Swap Papers. Just did a black square, did a little bit of colored lip blocking on top of that. The film strip is from Chamel Lane's die cuts. You Are Loved came from a My Mind's Eye Adorbs. I cut it out of a Project Life card. Heidi, Hobby Lobby doily, and then this came from Michaels in the dollar like section. And I just added a stick pin and some twine and matted my photo. So that's it. Really basic, really simple. And then I love these enamel pink hearts. These are from the expo that I recently went to, and I love them. They're so cute. Bit of simplicity, but cute. And the next one, I have these two little girls covered up just because I don't have permission from their parents. This is of my daughter and her two little friends on the first day of school at the bus stop, and they're all, you know, dolled up in their first day of school outfits, and they just looked so adorable. And they're all seventh graders, and I just thought it was so fun. So I did some Heidi Swap papers. They're nice and bright. And this is a very eclectic mix of papers on this layout. These are from a My Mind's Eye Jubilee, these die cut flowers here, and this adorable, and these arrows and flags are all from one of the My Mind's Eye Jubilee collections. I actually won a little die set at the retreat, so I use that. This is a Prima flower, and I think this die cut also might be from another pack of My Mind's Eye dies. And then there's a number 3 to represent the 3 girls. And then I have tucked in here some of those gold doilies from Hobby Lobby. And I just kind of cut them and, you know, added them in. So did a little bit of doodling and added some twine. And I really love how this one turned out. The next one was one of the very first layouts that I actually did at the retreat. And it was probably, 11 o'clock at night, and I just had this like energy burst. I had just dinner kind of late, and I was kind of like, oh, I'm in my groove. And so I was really excited that I just pumped this thing out. I haven't done my journaling yet on it, but I love it. The background paper is from the Adorbs collection from My Mind's Eye, along with this journaling spot. And all these layered stickers also are from a My Mind's Eye collection. I believe it might be the same one, or Spread Your Wings and Fly. Kind of mixed a bunch of them together. The cuteness on the side here, this is Heidi Swap, and then these are American Crafts along with the butterflies. And they are, you know, I could put some dimensionals under there so it makes their wings look like they're flying. I just added a piece of Star Vellum in the background, and that is from Hobby Lobby. And that's pretty much it. I just thought it went together really fast, but it turned out really, really cute. And then this one I made that same night when I was on a roll. And this is, I think it's so funny because I went out to lunch with my husband at a taco shop, and they had $5 margaritas, and they were humongous. They were like this big. I had to take a picture of it because I was just like, oh my gosh. And so I thought it was funny because I thought it was the perfect photo op. And so I just used a bunch of papers. This background paper actually is from one of the My Mind's Eye Jubilee collections. And I actually bought that collection at the retreat. It's the travel one. And this paper here that has all the hashtags on it actually came from the My Mind's Eye class. And then the other stuff, I just kind of threw it in. And this flower paper actually is the backside of this polka dot. And I wanted some of that flower paper in there because the colors were perfect. So I just cut out a square in the back, and then you can't see it once I do my layout. So I just did, I have 4 photos here, and then really simple. It's nothing complicated at all. This is some layering of some of the stickers, and I put dimensionals on there. And I really like how that came out. I think it's funny. And this one here is an old picture of my kiddos and 2 of our best friends, their children, and we travel with them a lot. And so I have a lot of photos of our kids and their kids together. And so we go camping all the time at Yogi Bear, which our kids are actually starting to outgrow, so we're a little bit sad about that. But here's a photo of them when they were younger, and so I thought I would go ahead and just get that memory down before I forget. And so I just did some of the Adorbs paper, a big fishtail banner, and then I just kind of randomly cut this pink paper, added some of the Adorbs buttons, and all these dimensional stickers and stickers all are from the same collection. And I just added those on and did a little bit of doodling. And there is dimension. So really simple. And then this one I also did that night where I had just a bunch of energy. And I love this one. It's super simple. It's just white cardstock textured. I put 2 huge banners on here that were from the Heidi Swap collection. I added the photo of me with my friends at a cocktail hour. I matted it with some green paper. And all the stickers you see on here are from a sticker collection that I got at the Scrapbook Expo that I shared with. It was, I believe, Soft Spoken brand. But I knew that I had cocktails with my friends and that I needed those stickers. So these kind of look like thickers to me, the glittery thickers. And so they're really cute. And then the cherries came from that collection as well as these enamel squares that say celebrate good friends and party time. So I did some stamping on here. I'm really proud of myself. I've been trying to use up my stamps in my scrapbooking. So I stamped on the frames And then I stamped smaller frames and then put these little enamel squares in the smaller frames, and then I stamped hearts in the bigger ones. I added enamel dots they're randomly everywhere on here in all different colors. There's gold Heidi swap mist everywhere, just splatters. And then this is a Pink Fresh Studio camera wood veneer that's colored. And I think this one turned out so cute. I really love this, how it turned out. My stamping isn't perfect, but you know it's homemade, and that's what I like about it. Those are all the layouts that I made at the Scrapbook Retreat in Utah. And so all the layouts I'm going to share with you now are layouts that I made in the last day, trying to finish up the paper kit that I put together that I took with me so that I can start using some other goodies that I purchased at the retreat, because, you know, I'm dying to use those. Okay, so this is the My Mind's Eye Adorbs paper, and I used a Kiwi Lane template up at the top. I pulled out some old die cuts that I had close to my desk that I'm just trying to use up all these die cut packets. These are Kay & Company, really old, and all the flowers, this family, all these die cuts are from that same pack. Here's a very pale pink doily from Hobby Lobby, and these words up here as well are die cuts. They inspire special photo and memories. And so I actually labeled this, you can't really tell, but unless you look at my journaling, but it says selfies with my mama. And so I thought it was so funny because I'm like, Mom, let's take a selfie. And so she's probably had no clue what a selfie was, but I thought that was funny. So I thought that turned out really cute of us. And then this one is of my kiddos. We went to the Steak and Shake for the very first time this summer while visiting our grandparents. And so I thought it would be so fun to do a little layout on this. And it was perfect because I found in my stash this guest check. And I was like, oh my gosh, I have to use this. It's perfect. So this came from a basic gray. I actually pulled a few things in while I was creating this because I had to. The guest check and all of these little banners here, and all the little pieces of art here, the little pieces of dies, all came from the basic gray. I think it's the Hey Boy collection. And so I just randomly put papers. The square with the cream and pink is from Chamel Lane, along with this kind of arrow paper as well. Just some navy cardstock in the backs, and then I just layered, you know, randomly put some enamel dots. These are some Eric Thickers down here that say Steak and Shake. I did my journaling. Here's a geotag with a heart, and it's colored yellow, and that is by Pink Fresh Studio. And yeah, I think this one turned out so cute. There's some vellum pieces on here, like this thumb and this little border here. So I think that turned out so cute. It's very clean and simple, but I really like it. And then this one is super, super easy. I have these pictures of my kids from when they were little in the backyard playing in the little blow-up pool. And I've had these printed for a really long time, and I'm like, ugh, I just don't know what to do with them. So I just stacked them up. I used a Kiwi Lane template, used some paper that was in the blue tones with a gradient, and then I had this Project Life card that said sunshine in summertime, along with some My Mind's Eye dimensional stickers, sunny side up, good day sunshine. And then I found this vellum from the Die Cuts of the View springtime collection, Here Comes the Sun, and I thought that was perfect. Just did a few little splatters of enamel dots in the orange, yellow, and turquoise, and called it a day. So that one's done. This is a favorite of mine. I think this one turned out so adorable. The paper collection on this one is from the My Mind's Eye Adorbs. And basically these top three cards are the pocket page cards. And then the bottom ones I actually had to cut with some leftover pattern papers. Just did some squared off areas and some strips, added my photo, and then did some layering of some of the die cuts from one of the Jubilee collections in the Adorbs My Mind's Eye collection. This is a Bella Boulevard crocheted heart, and a jelly bean soup little label thing down here, and then just added on buttons. And I think this one turned out so cute. I just love how it goes so well with the shirt that my daughter is wearing and her cute little smile on her face. All right, so this one took me a long time. I did some sewing on it and just was kind of playing around with sprays and inks and stamps, and this is what I came up with. So it's a picture of my youngest son. I used a white Me and My Big Ideas clear sticker that says "You're awesome." I used a stamp from a boy set that I have that has a bunch of different boy sayings. I just stamped half of the paper up the top. I actually cut this Heidi Swap paper into pieces, and there's two different patterns here, and I sewed them together onto a white cardstock, and that's where I stamped the background. I did some layering with some jelly bean soup little ephemeras, and then these are just some little sticky bobble things, and I have a little butterfly up here, a little man and an arrow, and some washi tape. Here's some little banners down here that I doodled around, and some more washi layering up there behind the photo. So that's basically what I did with some spraying. So you can kind of see the stitching right there from my sewing machine. Butterfly, and then up here is all the different stamps that I use. Just kind of make my own background. I was just in the mood to kind of play around with ink and sprays that night. And then this one is of my kids when they were smaller, and I am having problems with these Chamel Lane. Oh no, it probably ruined my photo. Yep. Well, I guess that's gonna stay there. Well, these cork stickers don't stick very well, and I can tell that it definitely moved. It's supposed to be over here, so I'm gonna have to probably add something over here when I finish making this video, because it's already wrecked my photo. So this is a picture of my dad with my two of my kids when they were younger, and it's really basic, just some random pattern papers in the back. I loved this chevron two-toned paper. I was just adding, this is Chamel Lane and Chamel Lane down here, and this is My Mind's Eye. There's some buttons up here which are My Mind's Eye as well, and there's some Prima flowers and a jelly bean soup label. But now I'm going to have to add something and try to fix that mess right there over top of my photo. Ugh, drives me crazy when things don't stick. Kind of makes me mad because we pay like, you know, $5 for a pack of embellishments, and then they don't stick, and then you have to reuse glue. Alright, so this one is of my oldest and my youngest when they were younger, and so this was just at this point the paper was a scrap piece of paper, but I needed some cutie looking embellishments. So this is actually from the Sweet Girl by Echo Park sticker sheet that I had, and I just grabbed that. It was close to my desk, and I just did a bunch of stickers on this one. American Crafts pinwheel up here, and that's basically it. I did some journaling here. I'm not sure if my camera will pick that up because it's in a gray pen. I didn't want it to take away from the layout, so I did it in gray, but I did journal. So that's a really super simple layout. And then this is probably one of my favorite layouts that I've did while I've been home, and this is using the Heidi Swap Dream Collection. And I actually took this idea from the paper that comes in the collection pack. There's a sample on the back of it, and I thought, ooh, I really like that, because really, what would you do with this background paper? It's kind of very busy with all the words. So I added this photo of my mom and my daughter when she was younger, and I did the clustering like they did. I used up some old supplies from Dear Lizzie on here. Here's another doily in a mint green, American Crafts little flower, rosette. Here's another one of those pink enamel hearts that I love. And just added a few stickers here and there. So I really like this cluster. It turned out really cute. So I really think that's one of my favorite layouts that I've made since I've been home. So that's a lot of layouts. I haven't even counted, so let's count and see. Since I've been home, I made 1, 2, 3, four, five, six, seven, eight. I made eight layouts since I've been home. And then let's count in. I think I made nine at the retreat. There's nine, or one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So that's a lot of layouts. I actually made a few more layouts from the retreat, from the classes, but I'm not going to share those with you right now, only because I want to kind of keep those separate. So that's quite a few layouts for me. I'm really excited that I got this giant stack. Look at all that. This giant stack of layouts completed at the retreat and at home using a lot of my supplies that I already had that I took with me. So I'm really excited about that. So guys, thanks so much for letting me share my Kiwi Lane projects with you that I had up on their blog, as well as the layouts that I made at the scrapbook retreat and the layouts that I've just recently made in the last day or two. So I will be back to share with you my video with the scrapbook stills class that they offered, and probably my haul as well that I purchased from Scrapbook Steals while I was there. All right, guys, thanks so much for stopping by. Have a good day. Bye now.